ओके, गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी। आई एम वंस अगेन हियर विद अ शॉर्ट लेक्चर ऑफ 8th सेमेस्टर, दैट इज प्रोडक्ट डिजाइनिंग। सो इन दैट पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट एंड द टॉपिक दैट वी आर कवरिंग स्टेप बाय स्टेप, अपार्ट फ्रॉम द शॉप फ्लोर कंट्रोलिंग एलिमेंट दैट वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग after a short after completion of all the technologies that I have mentioned in the early lectures. So in the last few lectures we have seen the discussion regarding the concurrent engineering, its approach, and we have also seen with the help of the various graphs that how concurrent engineering is beneficial in the designing of the product and capturing the market by keeping the interest of the customer, and how to satisfy the customer and keep the customer attracted with the product that are floating to the market of a particular form, and how product redesign can be done with the less input of monetary funds, and how it is helpful in reduction of the manufacturing lead time that we have seen yesterday with the help of the graph. And moving ahead with one more technology that is used for improvement of the quality of the product. Rather, it is if you just recall the product life cycle, and if you see the part of the graph that I have drawn, in that before the product goes to the downfall stage, that is when after maturity it goes down. So at the peak point I have drawn a line that is known as the extension line. So that is the part, or that is the point where product redesign or renovation can take place. Of course, these all technologies that we are discussing, these are all implemented from the origin itself, but if competition is tough and one has to capture the market, so designing extension can be taken into consideration before the decline of the product and at the maturity. Between the maturity and the decline. So one can take the risk. Of course, risk management and risk analysis is also one of the part that deals with the product designing, but we are not going into the much detail. And let me tell you one thing, that the part of the tribology that is in the syllabus of your product design, that contains the part of maintenance as well as the friction, wear and tear. So this part, it will be there in the subject of your tribology in the much detail. So I am not taking this part into my discussion. So the next approach that I will be taking in the discussion is your quality function deployment. Now this is also one of the systematic approach in which the feedback is taken from the market or from the customers by distributing the form and making a house of quality, in which various parameters of the customer that are need to be converted for improvement of the product design are correlated to its technical aspect. With the help of a instrument, or with the help of the graph, or rather I should say with the help of a comparative study that is known as house of quality, which also involves the equivalent factors that the competitive product is having and how to compare the competitive product with your product, and what are the technical aspects that are required for the improvement and how these technical aspects are related to the customer's requirement. So these are correlated and they give us the clear picture so that how we can improve our product or our design of the product can be improved. So quality function deployment may be defined as a systematic process to identify and prioritize customer requirements and to translate these requirements into product and process specifications. In the traditional process, there has been insufficient attention to the customer requirement. Traditionally, more emphasis has been made on satisfaction of technical specializations or technical specialists rather than the satisfaction of the customer. And nowadays we all know that the customer requirement is the priority, which is fulfilling the technical aspects also. So it's very important to capture the customer needs. So this is one of the approach which was started in Japan, in United States, and it has been in the action since 1967. And many companies in India also, they have been utilizing this, but nowadays it has been utilized much more for the improvement of the quality, and it has been used for reciprocating the requirements of the customer so that the product should be modified. So many management gurus such as Graven, Closing has given the definition of the quality function deployment, and I want to just say that manufacturing startup and pre-production costs reduces to 80%. The product development also reduces by 33% with the corresponding improvement of the quality, of the reduction of number of engineering changes. Research has come out with the point while utilizing the quality function deployment approach. So according to Graven, quality function deployment may be defined as an elaborated chart to translate perceptions of quality into product characteristics and product characteristics into fabrication and assembly requirements. Bossart has said that quality function deployment is a process that provides structure to the development cycle where the primary focus is on the customer requirement. So many such definitions has been given by various quality improvement gurus, in which the priority is the improvement of the product by keeping in the satisfaction or the priorities of the customer. So I am just going into the detail what are the benefits of quality function deployment with its application. As I have discussed that it converts the need by technically correlating the customer's requirement. So it helps in building up the database by meeting the customer requirements that is useful in the future. Improves the information regarding the designing, builds up the database regarding designing, about planning and continuous improvement activities, etc., as well as about the competitors' products that is in continuous competition. Ensures the consistency between the customer requirement and measurable characteristics of the product. Defines the product specification that meets the customer requirement while taking into the consideration the competitor into the market also. So these are some of the improvements also. It reduces the product lead time, increases the customer satisfaction, reduces the warranty claims, and also ensures the consistency between planning and production, improves quality, company performance, product reliability, opportunity and decision making. So these were the some of the applications and advantages of quality function deployment. So on the blackboard I will be drawing different phases of designing, manufacturing and validation, and in that I will plot a graph that will clearly show that how traditional approach varies with the quality function deployment approach on the graph, on which y-axis has resources and efforts and on x-axis we have the product development phases. So in the subsequent lecture I will be discussing this thing.